God's protection. Somebody say God's protection.
God's protection.
All right. God's protection means that you stand your ground. That's what God's protection means. You stand your ground. Let's go to Exodus 14 and 13. Exodus 14 and 13. I think that's a good place to start right there. Good place to start. Exodus 14, 13. Watch this here. And it says, and Moses said unto the people, fear ye not, stand still, and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will show you when? Tomorrow.
Today.
Next year.
Today.
5 minutes from now.
Today.
For the Egyptians, for your bills, for your poor health, for your poor eyesight, for your backaches, your enemies, for your failed marriages, for your job acting crazy with you. For the Egyptians whom you have seen, what?
Today.
You shall see them again no more forever. The Lord shall fight for you, and he shall hold your what?
Peace.
Let me pray. Heavenly Lord and Father, I thank you and I praise you for your word, for your word is truth. And we thank you, Lord God, and we honor you, Lord God, that there is none like you, Lord God. So we choose today that whatever what we're dealing with, whatever what we're going through, we're going to hold our peace. For the battle is already won. So, Lord God, we honor you, we thank you, we give you praise and glory. In Jesus' name. And everybody said?
Amen.
All right. Let me read my little intro right here. It said, my intro is this here. The protection of God. Stand your ground. Why are there so many believers scared to stand up for righteousness? Mm-hmm. Why are there so many closet believers? Why are there so many preachers that say they are called to preach the good news, scared to preach the good news? What's in the Bible that make men twist the word of God in front of the camera? Why are there so many Christians bad-mouthing other Christians that choose to stand for something that goes against immoral ways? The answer, I believe, is this, the great falling away. There must be a great falling away before Jesus come back. Let's go to 2 Thessalonians 2 and 3. 2 Thessalonians 2 and 3. Oh, yeah. It says this here. It says, let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come except there come a falling away second. Third. Except there come a falling away fifth.
First.
And that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition. It said, let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come except there come. Somebody say come.
Come.
All right. A falling away first. Just be not in that number. Don't fall into the category of falling away first. Because the devil is coming in so many different directions into our life that will cause to shake our faith. He'll cause you to have trouble in your marriage, trouble with your kids, trouble at your house, trouble at your job. But the main goal of the enemy is to get you to fall away. That's his number one goal. If you don't study the word of God for yourself, you will indeed fall away. It's just a matter of time. This church is built on us looking at the word of God for ourselves. You cannot go through this world without knowing the word of God. You can't do this type of ministry. You cannot survive. It's just a matter of time before you will fall away. All you need is the right worldview. Somebody say worldview.
Worldview.
That's all you need is the right worldview, and you will follow. The world is constantly trying to shape what you believe. Somebody say what I believe.
What I believe.
If you don't believe, let's do a quick test. on your worldview. Number one, do you love everybody by overlooking their sin? Mm-hmm. Yeah, because this world is a universal world that's trying to get all the religions to come together, all under the banner of love. So do you overlook people's sin by that word called love? The Bible said that love covers a multitude of sin, but that's not talking about what we're dealing with today. Just at my job, we was in a meeting and we had a training, and it was talking about, the whole thing was talking about getting along with other co-workers, but the main topic was the clients. It's always about the clients. It's always about those inmates out there. But the inmates is small potatoes. But the mere focus that I got, it was talking about getting along with each other. So say for instance, if I'm in the room and I'm sitting there talking with Felicia about homosexuality, and somebody just happened to walk in and they come in and get a cup of coffee and they hear me and then they confront me, now I have to use what they call tolerance. And at my job, they was trying to say that tolerance is a word that, it's a nice word in the general sense, because they were saying that you are considerate of other folks' needs. But we have this thing called, what does respect mean to you? Respect means to me that even though I hear your point of view, I may not agree with your point of view, but I respect your point of view.
Yeah, you're right.
If you want to go rob a store and you want to tell me about it, I say, well, okay, that's cool. That's what you go do. I respect it because you're going to go to jail or you're going to get shot. So if that's what you want to do, then you go ahead. Do you see what I'm saying? And so tolerance suggests that it doesn't matter what you think. You're going to believe what I believe, or I'm going to put the hammer on you. Respect means that I respect you as a human being, I respect your point of view, and even though I don't agree, we can still dap it up and go on about our business. But I sensed something that was going on, that just because you don't agree with me or I don't agree with you, I'm not saying anything to you. That's how it works out there. I don't know where it works anywhere else, but that's how it works out there. And a lot of people have a tendency of using the word of God, and they try to use the word in the context that fit them by overlooking sin, but using that word love. Number two, do you laugh at dirty jokes about Christians? Do you spend a lot of time around people who don't know Scripture? Because they're going to give you their world view. And most of the time that's family and that's close friends. They have a form of godliness, but they deny the power. If they get a headache, they can't even cast a thing out. But they can tell you how to fix your marriage. They need to get somewhere. And you need to be bold enough to tell them to get somewhere and sit down.
Thank you.
Do you receive advice from people who don't have a relationship with Jesus? Meaning that they talk the talk, but their lifestyle is still walking contrary to what God's word says. They get ready to turn you. They get ready to turn you in just a matter of time. The next one, are you drawn to old habits, friends? You fantasize about old boyfriends and girlfriends. You part of that still work, because the Bible says in Romans 12:1 that I beseech thee therefore, brethren, by the mercy of God, that you present your what? Bodies as a living what?
Sacrifice.
What? Holy, acceptable unto who?
God.
Which is your what?
Reason.
And be not conformed to this what?
World
view. Alright, somebody read. The last one. After salvation, have you been delivered? If not, you will fall away, because the old man is still there. Do y'all see this? So why would God tell the Egyptians that, take a good look at these people, for what the people what you see now, you will see them no more. And then when I do this, you're going to hold, I'm going to fight for you, you're going to hold your peace. Well, that was a physical thing. Pharaoh and those boys was a physical thing. But the children of Israel had crossed over into the land of Canaan, where God said that it's 7 giants that you're going to have to conquer. All those Hittites. Right? He said, now you're going to have to go in to subdue this land. But what in essence, what was God talking about? He was talking about your body. He was talking about you going to have to get before me and lay before me and deal with these Amalekites, these Hittites, these Jebusite ways that's inside of you. Mm. Watch this. He said, because I'm going to fight for you.
Yeah.
And when I do this and I deliver you, you're going to hold your peace.
Hallelujah.
See the difference? Watch this here. I just got to start thinking of something. It said, watch this here. This is just an example of a person whose worldview is still controlled by the devil. The sad part is that most people don't even know that they are bound. I give you an example. Kim Burrell is hot right now. Kim, I hope you're looking at this. I hope somebody look at this and show this and you come holler at me. Watch this here. This is an example. This is Kim Burrell's situation. I believe that God used a foolish situation to open Kim's eyes so that she can see just how deceived she was.
Hallelujah.
Before it was too late.
Hallelujah.
Let me explain. Last year, Kim was hosting Sunday's Beth with her co-host. And this gay guy who stunk up the joint got mad at the host, and particularly at Kim for laughing at him while performing. Kim stated that she and the panel had already made a decision not to let him go through while he was singing. However, this gay guy was not happy. He singled out Kim. Why Kim and not the others? Great question. Y'all asked a great question. Simple. The enemy knew and recognized the spirit of the living God living in Kim and decided to attack. Mm-hmm. The problem was Kim didn't see it. The second one was she sung a song with Pharrell. She didn't see that. The third, she and Pharrell was scheduled to perform on the Ellen DeGeneres show. Question. The Bible says in 2 Corinthians 6:14, do not be unequally yoked together with who? For what fellowship has righteousness with lawlessness? And what communion has light with what?
Darkness.
The fourth thing that she missed. Though Kim was right in what she said about homosexuality, she was wrong for putting her mouth on Bishop Eddie Long. Yes, he done wrong, but he's still one of us. He's still one of us. Let's go to Psalms 105:15. Remember, the enemies that you see today, you won't see tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
And when God fights for you, you're going to hold your peace.
Amen.
Watch this here. Psalms 105:15. It says, touch not my what? And do my what? That means prophetess you to y'all. Okay? All right. Now watch this. I'm going somewhere with this here. Watch this here. Watch this here. It says, because when you touch the anointing of God, you cross over into a line of judgment. Because you're saying who God had picked, you don't approve of. That's what that's saying. Okay? Some of them don't believe. Let's go to 1 Samuel 26:7. 1 Samuel 26:7. Let's look at this. Let's look at the text. Let's look at the text. 1 Samuel 26:7. Watch this here. Let's go back up to 4. It says, David therefore sent out spies and understood that Saul was come in a very deed. And David arose and came to the place where Saul had pitched. And David beheld the place where Saul lay, and Abner the son of Ner, the captain of his host, and Saul lay in the trench, and the people pitched around him. Then answered David and said unto the Amalekite, the Hittite, and Abishai, the son of Zeruiah, brother of Joab, saying, who will go down with me to Saul to the camp? And Abishai said, I will go down with thee. And so David and Abishai came to the people by night. And behold, Saul was laying asleep within the trench, and his spear stuck where? In the ground by his bolster. And Abner people laid around him about. Then Abishai said to David, God hath delivered thine enemy into thy hand this day. Now therefore, let me smite him, I pray thee, with the spirit even to the earth at once. And I will not smite him again. This dude was a marksman. That's what the Bible is saying, he was a marksman. David said unto Abishai, destroy him what?
Not.
For who can stretch forth his hands against the Lord's what?
Anointed.
And be guiltless. I don't care what Eddie Long has done. His body of work across the nation is unprecedented that God had his hands on this man. Because if God wanted to take that man out and put him down, he would have done it. He would have done it. Okay, that's just not enough. Let's go to Galatians 6:1. See, you can tell when a person's been redeemed by the Lord because they will have mercy when you see a fallen patriot go down. You will see it. Watch this here. Galatians 6:1. It says, brethren, if a man be overtaken in a fault, ye which are what?
Spiritual.
Restore such a one in the spirit of what?
Meekness.
Considering thyself, lest thou also be what?
Tempted.
Verse 2. Bear ye one another's what?
Burdens.
And so fulfill the law of who?
Christ.
That settles it. That settles it. Okay, everybody got that?
Yeah.
All right, back to Kim. She was right, because, but the word came from the wrong well. She was out of order in the delivery. There should have been a man to deliver that message. She should have considered the scriptures on that particular matter. Her head was not covered. That's why she's being attacked. Now, she's on the internet trying to protect herself. When the Bible says over here in Exodus, it says, the people that you see today, right? You ain't gonna see them no more. For I'm gonna fight your battle, hold your peace. She's on the internet trying to defend herself. If you know that you said what was right, why do you need the world's approval?
Yes.
Yes. All right. 1 Corinthians 14. Gotta show you these things, y'all. Cause the devil is after your faith. 1 Corinthians 14, and let's go to verse 33. Let's put some order in this thing. Because the internet is full and the world is full. My job is full. Women out there put the word of God out there. Full. It gets up under my skin. Watch this here. It says, watch this here. It says, for God is not the author of what?
Confusion.
But of what?
Peace.
As in all churches of the saints. Now why did God put that there? I'm gonna tell you why he put that there. It's right up under this. Watch this here. It says, let your women keep silent in the what?
In the church.
For it is not permitted for them to what? But they are commanded to be under obedience, as also saith the what?
The law.
Not pastor. Okay, that's probably a little fun. If they will learn anything, let them ask their who?
Their husband.
And where?
At home.
She's on the internet. She's in the church. Now watch this here. It doesn't matter if you don't believe me. If God says, if God said, shouldn't it be settled?
Yeah.
How are we going to twist and dissect that?
Yeah.
Come on, man.
How are we going to twist and say, well, it does not mean that? It is what it is. God has made it where a child can understand the word of God. So how is it that when things come our way, we choose and pick and believe that God said this, but he hasn't said that?
That's right.
That was an old song. I forgot the black sheep. The Sunday said, you can get with this, you can get with that. That's what the world is saying, y'all.
Yeah.
You can get with this, you can get with that. In other words, you can pick and choose what you want.
Right.
I suggest in the kingdom of God, you got to take your stands and make your allegiance and make your election sure. Because the devil is going to attack anything that comes out of your mouth and anything that you stand for.
Yeah,
so it's this here.
That's right.
It's this. Ah. don't care what you say. I don't care what you say. Okay, let's go to 1 Corinthians 11. Let's go to 1 Corinthians 11. 11 and 3. Watch this here. 1 Corinthians 11 and 3. It says this here. But I would have you know that the head of every man is who?
Christ.
So even a man has to sit down and shut up at some point.
Right.
Who? Huh? Am I not? Okay. Who run this here? Who run this here?
God.
Now who's up under him?
You.
Who's up under me?
Me.
Thank you. So there's order in the house. It's order in the house. Okay. At your house, at my house, God is still head of the house.
Yeah.
I'm in control under God. Mm-hmm. We are co-heirs in that house. See the difference?
Mm-hmm.
In the church is God, man, the woman. Right?
Yeah.
In the house is God, us. But even though I'm held responsible, we are joint heirs in the affairs of our house. Because if my boy or anything that comes into our house trying to dictate things, I run it by her. That's why she's called a helpmeet.
Right.
She looks through my blind spots. She helps me in the places where I refuse to look. She helps me in the place where I don't see.
Yeah.
Two is always better than one.
Right.
Sir.
Come on. Oh yeah. That's why you single people need to hold on. They coming. It's cold out there. It's cold out there. Watch this here. Verse 4. Every man praying or prophesying, having his head covered, dishonor his what?
Hey.
But every woman that prayed or prophesied with her head uncovered, dishonored her what? Mm-hmm. You know what that's meaning? That's saying that is when she's renegading outside of the confines of her husband, she's uncovered. Anything is liable to happen. And that's what I see in this world today. That's what I see in this world today. It's a bunch of women out there. And this woman got in trouble because it just wasn't settled in her that she told the truth. She had to get up and explain why she told the truth. You ain't got to explain the truth when you lay down the law. When we tell RJ and Monty to do something, we ain't got to go back and say, well, I hear you. No. What we said is final.
Right?
Period.
Yes.
Oh, okay. You suck. Now, okay, look at verse 6. For if the woman be not covered, let her also be shown. But if it is a shame for a woman to be shown or shaven, let her be covered. For a man indeed ought not to cover his head, forasmuch as he is the image and glory of who?
God.
But the woman is the glory of who?
Man.
That's why she's hung out to dry. And that's why you got, watch this here. You will see a lot of women out there. They start off talking, but they start sounding like men.
Yeah.
Okay, that's not enough. Let's go to Ephesians. We're talking about the protection now. We're talking about the protection of God. Stand your ground. Watch this here. Ephesians 5:22. Watch this here. Let's go to verse 21. It says, submitting yourselves one to who?
Another.
In the fear of who? God.
Right.
Wives, submit yourselves unto your what? Own husband. As unto who?
The Lord.
For the husband is the head of the who?
Wife.
Even as Christ is head of the church. And he is savior of what? The body.
Yeah.
Do y'all see this? Okay.
Amen.
That's still not enough. You can watch this here. Let's go to Colossians 3:18. Watch this here. See, each one of these scriptures has a different meaning, but it's saying the same thing. But watch this. Why don't you catch this? Colossians 3:18. It says, wives, submit yourself unto your own what? As it is fit in the Lord. Whoa. Let's look at this fit. I put these clothes on. But I asked my wife, I said, the blue vest or the white vest? Mm-hmm. She said, the white vest, because it fit. Mm-hmm. If I would put on the blue, then that would have gave the enemy occasion to say to her, well, he don't value my what?
Opinion.
The Bible says in Genesis that God had found a suitable mate for who? Adam. He found a suitable mate. That means that he couldn't find, God didn't find another woman to fit what was originally fit for Eve.
Come on now.
Do y'all get this? This turns into how people look at theology. Just because God has given that woman or that man the word, all of a sudden the devil says, you're some great one. Now all of a sudden they start churches, they start small groups, they do this, and it's totally out of order. And the number one goal of the devil is for us to stray away in the word, thinking that we're using the word correctly, but we're going straight to hell. Suitable. God said this woman is suitable. If God wanted Adam to have all of these women, he would have laid Adam to sleep and probably be still doing the work today. He would have gave Latanya, Tamika, Kim, and Sharon. And each one of these women would have been suitable. And if God saw that it was good, we have to go with the text, because God is what? Good. But he saw that it was one.
Yeah.
He said, this woman is suitable. And right here it said that that as it is fit, that means that it fit. It feels good. I'm in a good place. I'm in a good space. I know that I'm in a good place because it fits.
Yeah. Amen. Come on, man.
Do that make sense?
Yes, sir.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Watch this here. Then it goes down. It says, children, obey your parents in what? All things. For this is well-pleasing unto the Lord. Do y'all see this?
Amen.
Oh, man. This is just not enough. I don't care what you say. It's just not enough. Let's go to Titus. I just got to show you these things now, because sometimes y'all, we get to a place where this thing gets out of hand. I just want to show you that it's a possibility that she got off somewhere. And when you get off from the word of God, you get to a place to where you become a renegade, and you don't even know that you're renegade. Do y'all see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And so when we look at Titus, watch this here. When somebody get Titus, somebody read Titus.
What chapter?
Oh, I'm sorry. Titus 2:5.
All right. To be discreet, chaste, homemakers, good, obedient to their own husbands, that the word of God may not be blasphemed.
Read it one more time.
I'm going to go to verse 4. That they admonish the young women to love their husbands, to love their children, to be discreet, chaste, homemakers, good, obedient to their own husbands, that the word of God may not be blasphemed.
Do y'all see that? Do y'all see that? So where is the proper place if a wife or a woman want to find God?
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And right here. Right there. It clearly says right there in 5 to be what? Discreet.
Discreet.
Chaste. Keepers at home. Good. Obedient to their what?
Their own husband.
How can you get a divorce behind that? You should be able to spot that wolf that's coming after your man in your house. Watch this here. To love their children. That the word of God be not what? Blasphemed. So that tells me there, ladies, that you can go to hell because you're blaspheming the word of God. Anything that's outside of what he just described in verse 5 is treason. That's why she got in trouble. It's hard to digest, but hang with God. Hang with God. Hang with God. Watch this here. 1 Peter. 1 Peter. We're going to get back to her. 1 Peter. But I have to show you this in the Word. Because if I just come up with it, it's almost like I'm lying. I'm just male shoulders. I've been like this. I'm arrogant and things like that. But when you see it for yourself, then you let the Holy Spirit deal. You wrestle with God on that. That goes for male and female. Watch this here. 1 Peter 3. 1. Watch this here. Likewise, ye wives, be in subjection to your own who?
Husband.
That if any obey not the word, they also may without the word be won by their what?
Conversation
with their what? Wow. So if you got that crazy hellion that's in your house that's not manning up and doing what's right, if you'll keep up at home, if you take care of the children, if you're doing what's right, if you don't blaspheme the word of God, if you don't try to preach to him, then he said your conversation would win him over. But they got to have a pulpit. Kim shouldn't have never been up there. Just because it seems right don't give you the right. I think it's right for me to tell these people that we shouldn't have to pay. Because after all, that was some miracles that took place up in here while we was here. Yeah. But guess what you think these folks gonna tell us? Get somewhere, sit down, and shut up. They ain't got nothing to say. They ain't trying to hear you. Do this make sense? Watch this here. Verse 2. While they behold your chastened conversation coupled with fear, they gonna fear what you say. Because it's not you. You're standing in your lane. Who's adorning? Let it be not that the outward adorning and the planting the hand, oh boy, we got a problem with that, and the wearing of gold or a putting on apparel. This is how the devil gets in, y'all. In most women's world, is all, and no matter what church I go to, they always got to get that half inch, they always got to get them clothes, they always got to get this stuff. You know what? But when you look at a modern day plain Jane woman, they don't want to look like that, but that woman is more connected to God, and her husband don't have no fear of another man.
Right.
I shall read it again. Watch this here. While they behold the chastening conversation coupled with fear, who's adorning, let me read the Amplified, it made a lot of sense. Let not yours be the merely external or adorning, elaborate, unwavering, unweaving, or knotting of the hair, the wearing of jewelry or exchange of clothes. But let it be the inward adorning and beauty of the hidden person of the heart with an incorruptible and unfading charm of a gentle and peaceful spirit, which not is anxious or wrought up, but is very precious in the sight of God.
Right.
When you take your time to spend 19,000 hours in the mirror, who are you really trying to reflect?
Go ahead, man.
It's in the text.
That's good.
It's in the text. That's part of the world system inside of us saying that we want to be accepted. We don't accept what we look like. We are made in the image of God. So when we stand there and just go to work for hours and you're changing and you're this and you're that and your husband is sitting right there, who in the world are you trying to impress?
Right.
Okay. God's protection. Stand your ground. Let's talk about the great escape. Back to her foolishness. I believe God was giving her a way of an escape. Somebody said way of an escape. When the children of Israel was coming out of Egypt, God gave them a way of an escape through the Red Sea. Do y'all see this here? It was a designed strategic plan by the hand of God. Watch this here. Not to get them to cross over, but to kill their enemies. When God told Joshua to take the people, command the people to go over, he told them, you're going to subdue the land little by little. But the days of miracles will cease. If you want it, you're going to have to plant it and you're going to have to eat it.
Wow.
Watch this here. Watch this here. With all the backlash she's getting and no support from her celebrity friends, she gets no support because they all on the same team. Yolanda Adams can't say anything because they all on the same team. She performed with Bone Thugs and Harmony. How's she gonna say something? How is Kirk Franklin gonna say something? These gospel artists that you play because the song is appealing to the soul and it just did something. Get somewhere, because if it's not about you being on your face before God worshiping, it's nothing. Is nothing.
Go ahead, man.
That's why we worship God. We worship God. We want the presence of God. We want. If I know how to get this body to rock and move with a song that rocks and makes my body feel good. I know how to do that. But nobody told me that when you get down on the face of God, you have to deny yourself.
Yes.
That's the great escape. It's on your face, denying yourself. Because it's not about me anyway.
Amen.
She was all alone out there now. Isn't she all alone out there? Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, you better believe not one person coming to her defense, because they all on the same team. Mm-hmm. In other words, God is showing her, I'm showing you what you are like, but I'm giving you the way of an escape.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow. Watch this. God could be granting her mercy before the world gets her. God granted us mercy before the world got a hold of us.
Yeah.
Do you see?
Amen.
Okay, watch this here. Watch this here. She was scheduled to receive a Lifetime Achievement Award. They canceled her. She was scheduled to perform with Pharrell on the Ellen Show, which was canceled. I believe the Ellen Show would have opened the door for Kim to the homosexual world, opened the door for Hollywood, more recording contract that was sealed. It would have sealed her in losing her way. Do you see?
Yes.
It would have opened the door. Because she wouldn't have got on that show talking about salvation and the plans. She would have talked about the song and the collaboration and this year happened and it was so good that we got together and boy, look what it did. And boy, and it's going to open that door, because opening up that homosexual world opens doors. That's why you have that word intolerance or tolerance. It has to be displayed in the workplace. It has to be displayed in when you go downtown. It has to be displayed in the public. So when you see, okay, thank you, Lord. Tolerance came from the LGBT community. It did not come from slavery. It did not come from the color of your skin. Because white folks was very intolerant because of the color of our skin. It came through the way of the LGBT. That's why I had a problem at my job in that training. Because I saw the devil. I saw him. He wants to shut down my faith-based views by saying, if I can't get you to shut up in the church, I'm going to get you to shut up where it really matters. And it's a shame that you got some yellow belly, broke wrist, broke back, mouth. It's on the camera. It's on the tape. Christians, that's a shame of the gospel of Jesus Christ. The very thing that saved them, that brought them out of a dungeon, that brought them out of a prison and a pit. They're going to sit here and paint it on the wall, but they can't let it come out of their mouth. Genius of the devil. Genius of the devil. He was giving this woman a way out. Because he knew that if she opened up that door, there is no turning back.
Yes.
No turning back. No turning back. Proverbs 14:12. Proverbs 14:12. Coming out of Egypt, he said, take a look at these people. For what you see today, you will not see no more. He said, because I'm going to fight for you. And you're going to hold your what?
Peace.
Proverbs 14:12, it said, there is a way which seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof is the ways of death. The ways of death. It means that the lifestyle, each step that you take into a different endeavor, it's a way, it's ways that you're going to find death by you thinking that you're doing the right thing. It seems right. I'm going to witness to somebody. I'm gonna share the gospel. You know what's wrong with me going on? You always coming with some stuff. Every time I look at you, you always got stuff going. Nobody can never have no fun. You always serious. Name me a place where the Bible said that the devil comes to joke around. It may seem like I'm screaming and yelling, but I'm trying. I'm not, you know. Watch this here. Watch this here. That's the way that seems right. Have you ever made a decision without consulting God? See, we can't just throw her under the bus, because we all have made decisions without consulting God. Have you ever said or did things that you thought was God, but the enemy turned it against you because it wasn't God, but you thought it was God, because that's the way that seems right. Do you see? On our best day, it just seems right. But the end thereof is death. But right in the middle of our mistakes and bad decisions, thank God for mercy. God stepped in and gave us mercy. He didn't excuse the sin, but he taught us how we could learn and grow from our mistakes. We serve a good God. We are talking about God's protection. If you have been married and now divorced and have made bad decisions in picking a particular career or partner or whatever, thank God that his hand of protection, because it could have been worse. Mercy said no. God said, I'm going to turn this and get glory. That's a good place to clap right there. Hallelujah. We all made some bad stuff, man. We all made some bad choices, man. We all fell short. We all did some things that we thought it was God. It was just the right thing to do. You know, you took your money and you blessed somebody and you wonder why you went hungry, because God didn't tell you to do that. It was a good gesture, but God didn't tell you to do that. Because sometimes you can hinder a person from hearing God, or that God can do something for you, because you got your hand always extended out to them. You got a word for them always. Sometimes you just gotta look, and the guy that's on the map, you gotta look at this guy and say, I'm just gonna pray for you, and I'm gonna pray that God give you the strength to get up. Now I'm going on about my business. But we always have the tendency of wanting to sit there and hear people stuff. Then get somewhere and sit down, shut up, because we ain't got nothing to say.
That's what I'm talking about.
I just pray for you, brother. I just pray that God will give you the sense that you can get up yourself.
Yes.
It's been done. How long have you been sitting here? 38 years. I didn't have nobody to put me in. Do thou want to be made whole? Well, I don't have nobody to put me in. Every time the angel come, they stir up, they go before me. Man, pick up your mat and go home.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Right?
Go ahead,
now. We're talking about God's protection.
Yeah.
God's protection. 1 Timothy 4:1. It just seems right, y'all. It just seems right. But we're looking at God's protection. We stand our ground. We stand our ground. Why is it people is never saying anything? Why people don't say, why are these heavy hitters that got these big multi-million-dollar ministries never saying anything, that we buy their books and they teach? And they don't speak on the matters that's dear to our God. How dare we? That's treason. I just bought the book, 7 Steps to Freedom. 7 Steps to Financial Freedom and 13 Steps to Deliverance. Get in your word. Get in your on your face before God. Turn down your plate and stand and see the salvation of the Lord.
Yeah.
Amen. Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
Do y'all see? Watch this here. Watch this here. 1 Timothy 4:1. I charge thee before God, the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the what? Quick and the dead. At the appearance.
1 Timothy?
I'm sorry. What did I say?
You said 1 Timothy.
1 Timothy. Go to 2 Timothy. I'm sorry. 4:1. See, somebody caught that in the spirit. Look at Tommy. Yeah, I'm with you. I'm sorry, y'all. That's what happens when you get excited. Watch it. 1 Timothy 4:1. 2 Timothy 4:1. Watch this here. I charge thee before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the quick and the dead, at his appearing and his kingdom. Preach the word. Be instant in what?
Season.
Out of what?
Season.
What's that nasty word behind it we don't like? Reprove. Rebuke. Exhort with all long suffering and what? with the word of God. Now let's back up. Let's back up to 2 Timothy 3, 16. Because we got some, oh, I just don't agree with that. Watch this here. All scripture is given by inspiration of grandma.
God.
The government.
God.
Well, I got to do what these people say, because they told me don't preach out here on this job.
God.
They told me don't. They told me I better not say anything.
God.
Mm-hmm. All scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for what? Doctrine. And for what? Reproof. And for what? Correction. For instruction in what? God's protection. God's protection. When you have God's protection, you can take a stand. Because Satan don't have anything in you when you stand up for righteousness. You may stand by yourself, and you will, because your mama, daddy, sister, cousin, and brother, they are supposed to come against you because you have the true and living word. They just have the word. You have the true and living word. It's living and breathing. How you can tell? Because they don't want you to come to this church. How you can tell? Because it ain't nothing happening. You need to stay in this traditional way. How you can tell? Because they coming against everything that you say. How does he tell? Because when you walk into the room, they be quiet.
That's what I'm saying.
Because they've been talking about you.
Yes, sir.
Your presence alone rebuke and reprove and correct. You don't all that time have to say nothing. Because sometimes you can smile crying without even saying nothing. Because he said, hold your peace. Go in there and get you a plate and just walk out and cry in the car. When you know God has been good to you, and you know when God has knocked some devils out of you, how can you bow down to the rope?
Go ahead, pal.
That's right. How can? 1 Timothy 4 and 1. I got this one right, please. You said. No, man. Watch this here. 1 Timothy 4:4-1. Watch this here. Watch this here. It says now. Somebody say now.
Now.
The Spirit speaking expressly. That means it's hot off the press. That means UPS is coming by. Yeah. That means that all the trucks that make fast delivery, this is overnight service.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Expressly. Watch this here. That in the latter who? Times. Some shall depart from the what?
From the faith.
Giving heed to who? And doctrines of what?
Yeah.
Okay, let's break this thing down. Let's break this thing down. Let's look at 1 Timothy and break this thing down. Because I notice in this church, we use this scripture a lot. Mm-hmm. Let me tell you, watch this here. The first, they don't know how to discern the times. This is how you can tell people who don't know God. They do not know how to discern the times. Luke 14. They don't know. They just go to talking. They just say stuff. And the word God says is here. But you look for the fruits in their life, you cannot find. Luke 14. I'm in the wrong scripture, y'all. I'm sorry. Let's go to Matthew. Luke 21. I'm sorry. I'm tripping. Luke 21. 21. You wouldn't do that with your boss. Watch this here. Luke 21 and 28. Watch this here. Then Peter said, Lord, we have left all and followed thee. Watch this here.
What?
I'm tripping, man. Luke 21 and 28. Watch this here. It says, and when these things begin to come to pass, then look up and lift up your heads, for your redemption draweth nigh. Watch this here. Back up to verse 26. It says, men's hearts faileth them for what? Fear. For looking after those things that are coming upon the what?
On the earth.
For the powers of heaven shall be shaken, and then shall they see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with what? Power and great glory. And when these things begin to come to pass, then look up and lift up your heads, for your redemption draweth nigh. These people don't know the signs. It's a car. understood the signs. Let's go to First Chronicles. Issachar understood the signs. You got to understand the sign. You just can't keep holding your hat on Matthew 24, where it talks about, you know, when the disciples asked Jesus, when shall we know? And Jesus said, I pray that you don't be deceived. You got to be more astute than that. You got to be more astute in the word than that. You got to be able to know how to discern the times. And we found this in 1 Chronicles 12 and 32. It says right this here. And the children of Issachar, which were men that had understanding of the what?
Time.
To know what Israel ought to do. To know what the Jackson house ought to do. To know what the Jones's house ought. Do y'all see this?
Amen.
You should know what to do. The heads of them that were 200 and all of the brethren were at their command. You should know. You should know in the 9,000 years you've been saved, what kind of battle plan do you have when the devil shows up at your door? You should discern the time. When the devil shows up at a person's house, he shows up when a curse comes at your house, it is the devil coming against your house. So you should be able to discern the time. If the devil comes against your house, you should back this thing up and say, now what have we done right here? What is going on right here? Are we tithers? Are we givers? Are we in the house of God? Are we doing this? Are we doing that? You should be able to discern the time, because the curse without cause shall not come alive. In other words, if the door is closed, the devil cannot come in. But if the times is, if you don't discern the time, then the devil can come in at will. 1 Timothy 4:1 says that the Spirit of God speaks expressly. We're talking about the latter time. The first thing that most people don't do, because they have the world view, they do not know how to discern the time. If you don't know, now you know. 1 Chronicles 12:32. Study Issachar. The second thing, they depart. They depart. They have no word in them. This is still from the same scripture. For that in the latter time they shall depart. Well, what are they departing from? Because they have no word. Let's go to Romans 1:28. Romans 1:28. You're going to get a lot of scriptures in this church. He just don't preach right. He just don't. Oh, be quiet. Watch this here, because you're going to get it up in here. Watch this here. And even as they did not like to retain God in their what?
In their knowledge.
God gave them over to a what?
Reprobate.
To do those things which are what? Not convenient. So they got to depart. They got to leave. They got to leave, y'all. Watch this here. Let me show you what this word depart means. Depart means abandon, walk away, turn, to be a lord. Make a conscious decision to walk away, because they never belonged. 2 Thessalonians 2:10. I'm coming to a close. Hey man, I'm tired of these scriptures, man. 2 Thessalonians 2:10. You got to see it. You got to see it for yourself, because seeing is believing. Do y'all see that? 2 Thessalonians 2:10. Watch this here. It says, and with all deceivableness of unrighteousness in them that perish, because they receive not the love of the what?
Truth.
That they might be what?
Saved.
They don't want the truth. So they can't be saved. So they have to what? Depart. This is all in this scripture right here. John 10:27, this is for time's sake. It says, my sheep hear my voice. And the God says, I know them, and they follow me. My sheep know my voice. We keep getting counsel from people, because the devil had found a lonely and tender spot in our hearts. And we get counsel, unwise counsel. There's a way that seems right. But God says, my sheep know my voice, and I know them.
Right.
Does this make sense, y'all?
Yes.
The third thing, they depart from the faith. 2 Peter 2:20. They depart from the faith. They don't have nothing in them. They don't have anything in them. 2 Peter 2:20. 20. Watch this here. For if after they have escaped the pollution of the world through the knowledge of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, they are again entangled therein and overcome, and the latter end is worse with them than the beginning. See how I went back to that word in the latter times? They're latter. Because they have no faith. So they have to depart. Because they don't understand the times. Watch this here. John 6:66. I'm going to show you something real interesting in this here. Watch this here. John 6:66. I wonder if y'all caught that.
666.
Uh-huh. It's there. Watch the scripture that is there. It says, from that time, many of his disciples went what? Back and walked no more with him. Meaning they received the mark. Isn't it kind of strange that John 6:66 is there? Do y'all see? Hebrews 3:13. I mean 3:12. You gotta see it, y'all, because this is God's protection. This is how God protects us. You got to be able to put your eyes on the scriptures. So when you begin to act crazy, the Bible says that the memory of the righteous is blessed. And if you belong to God and God knows you, he's gonna quicken you. You may not even remember the whole full scripture, but you're gonna be able to put some of this pie together to make an intelligent decision.
Amen.
Chop up the scripture. They just battered and bruised. If the scripture was alive, you'd be like, oh, ow, oh, it just chopped. Oh, you just did me up because it just chopped all over. But it's enough. It's enough to stop them. Thou shalt not steal. Well, I thought about that the other day, man, but I just know where it says somewhere in the thou shalt not what not steal. Oh, I just started to pay for it. I could have stole. I walked out of the store. I came back and I paid for it.
Go ahead, though.
Watch this in Hebrew 3:12. Take heed, brother, lest there be any of you an evil heart of unbelief in departing from the living God. The world is after your faith-based views. They're trying to exchange it with unbelief. That just because the circumstances that's happening in your right now life, they're going to put a worldview there and say, this is the better way. So you can come to a place where you don't believe and you walk away from the living God. Why it says living God? Because you have tasted him.
Mm-hmm. Jesus.
You have tasted him. You know everybody can't say that.
That's right.
Have you ever seen somebody in the backslidden condition? You say, man, why are you out there? You know God. You know the power of God. You know what God. And they turn around and say, yeah. You know, I know. Mm-hmm. I know. And they avoid you. They avoid you because you walking in the fullness of a living God. You may not feel like you have Christ. You may not act like you have Christ from time to time. But he said, greater is he that's in who?
Me.
Than he that is in this world. So anybody that we run up against and we have the living God in us, it brings reproof, rebuke, and correction.
Go ahead, man.
Don't let the devil fool you. Your righteous stand do mean something. Matthew 24. Man, you said that was the last scripture. Watch this here. Matthew 24. This stuff is God's protection. Watch this here. Matthew 24 and 12. It says this here, y'all. It says, because of iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax what?
Cold.
Don't let the flame of the Lord burn out.
Hallelujah.
Because you will wax cold. You will be hard. You will see, you'll get to the place where you will see people going to hell and you will say you ain't telling them nothing because they done said or done something to you. You better not get to that place.
Amen.
Okay. Last one, then we'll pick this up next week. Galatians 1:18. You have to search the scriptures for yourself. We all big people up in here. And if you don't know Now you know. Because the word of God is rich. The word of God is just, it should be something dear to you. Galatians 1 and 8. I'm sorry, yeah, 1 and 8 and 9. It says, but though we, or an angel from heaven, preach any other gospel unto you than that which ye have preached unto you, let him be accursed. As we said before, so I say now again, if any man preach any other gospel unto you that ye have received, let him be accursed. Let me say this here. Y'all look at me. If I come to you preach any other gospel other than what's been preached, if I twist the word of God, raise your hand, pack your stuff, and leave this false prophet. If I come next week and preach any other gospel other than what's in this book, and I twist and bend to make it say what I wanted to say, just don't walk in front of the camera. Just go on around, raise your hand, and walk out. Don't even allow me to bless you out because I'm a false prophet. If you see me on the street and I'm acting a plumb fool, call me up. Pray for me. And if I refuse to repent or hear you, bring another witness. And I refuse to hear the witness, bring me before the church. And if I still have the gall to get up here behind this pulpit and preach out of a hurt, sinful heart to where I'm sitting up here busting up clubs and I'm sitting up here doing my thing and I'm dishonoring my wife and my children, I'm doing this and do this, just quiet. Just get up and just walk out because I'm a false prophet.
Right. We're
talking about God's protection. We're not talking about if I fall into sin. It's when I fall into sin, I refuse to not come out of it.
That's right.
Because all has fallen short. All have sinned and fallen short of the glory of who?
God.
Don't judge the time before the matter, because we sure won't. We don't judge nobody in this place before the time because we don't have the full scoop of what's going on. But if it's a repeated pattern, now we got to put some light to that thing. Now we got to put the word of God on it, and it's still up to you. And we're just going to love you through this thing. We're going to long suffer. We're going to be patient, and we're going to do this thing. But we're going to see that God bring you out, and then you're going to watch this thing be destroyed in front of you. And then you're going to see God fight for you. And then you're going to hold your peace. What do you mean hold your peace? Hold your peace. You're going to be in wonder and awe that God really did that. When you see your bills say zero. When you see your children just all of a sudden just want to come in the house of God. You find them praying finally. When you see that the devil on your job is bowing down. When you see things begin to turn around, you're going to stand and say, only God could do something like this. And you're going to hold your peace. Amen?
Amen.